Hello viewers, in today's video we are going into the SAP system and we will check how to create an inquiry.
Now before I start, I want to say something very important. It is very evident that people are finding value from my videos. Now if you are really finding value, please like, share and subscribe to my channel.
Please check this data where it shows that 74% of my viewers are finding value from the videos, but they have not subscribed.
So I appeal to all the viewers to like, share and subscribe to my channel.
And please hit the bell icon so that you do not miss any notifications.
So here we see a holistic view of the order to cash process. Now the first section is the pre-sales activities, wherein the customer can contact us. They can have an inquiry. They may have a contract and a quotation. So these are the pre-sales activities where we can get inquiries from a potential customer. So after the customer confirms the order, we would create a sales order wherein we have to make the sale to the customer. After that, once the order has been processed, we would have to pack that product into a box and we have to deliver the product to the customer. We have to create a shipment and then send the product to the customer. Now sending the product is also called as goods issue. So once we issue the goods to the customer, we will send the billing document to the customer for payment. So the last step is the billing part. Now if we talk about transactions, it starts with inquiry. So V11 is for inquiry, and then we have a quotation wherein the customer gives a price, and once the prices are finalized, we will make a sales order. After sales order, we create an outbound delivery so that we can deliver the part to the customer. Then via VL02N, we can pick the quantity and as well as post the goods issue. And finally, we would do the billing via VF01.
So for creating an inquiry, you have to go into the SAP Easy Access screen and type in VA11. So you should remember this T code, it is VA11, and press enter. Now here we have to give an inquiry type. So normally the inquiry type is IN, so you can select inquiry from here, and then we have to give a sales organization. So whatever your sales organization is, you can give. So for example, my sales organization is suppose 1210, so I will give sales organization as 1210. The distribution channel would be what is my sales area, so whatever my sales area is, I would select that, and division will be this one. So after entering these, we would press enter. So once we press enter, we'll go into the screen wherein you have to put the sold to party, the ship to party and the material and the customer reference. So let's put the sold to party. So I have a good sold to party, that is this one, and the sold to party and ship to party will be these this number. Then I would have a good material, so let's take this material and the reference number. So I can give a reference number as test. So normally this reference number is the reference number that the customer has given you. So that when the customer has called you for an inquiry, you can put this customer reference number in this field. Now I give the order quantity for suppose 1 or 10. I give put 1 here. So I press enter. Now here you see the sold to party has come, the shipped to party has also come. Now this is the material. So and this is the order quantity. Now if I go inside, I want to show you a few things. This is the delivery date, and if I go to the sales B tab, so I can find the material group here, the customer group here. So these tabs are important. I would show you these tabs. If I go into the shipping tab, which is also important, I would have to mention the plant and the shipping point from where the material would go to the customer. Here, very important, I have to mention a storage location. So I can go to F4 and I would select a good storage location for sending the part. So the part is inside this storage location, and I'm creating a sales order wherein the part will go from this storage location. Now if I go to billing document, there are a lot of fields which we can check. We have the Incoterms. So in the conditions tab, these are the pricing details that is coming. We can go to schedule lines and check the confirmed quantity. So this is the delivery date and this is the confirmed quantity. If I go to order data, I can see the customer reference number here. And if I click here, I will be able to see more tabs like structure A and structure additional data A and additional data B. So after we have put all the relevant information, I would go to back here and then I would check the inconsistency or the consistency of the document. So I click on incompletion log. If I click on incompletion log, this message is very important. So the document is complete. So if you get the message document is complete, that means that there are no errors inside this document and you are good to post. So once the document is completed, I will click on save. So once I click on save, I will have the document number. So here you can see an inquiry has been created with this number. So if I want to, if I can copy it and if I show, I can display it. So if I go to /NVA13, I will be able to see the same inquiry number. If I press enter, I will be able to see all the details. So this is the inquiry number, the sold to party, the customer reference number and the dates. If I go inside, and these are the details. I go to shipping tab. This is the good plant and the shipping point and the storage location. So this is the way how we create an inquiry. So in the next video, I will continue with the order to cash cycle. We would show how do we create a quotation. So till we meet again, do take care and goodbye.